Does your family have a favorite kind of floral arrangement for special occasions? Because different flower families do, and we classify them according to how their floral whorl is arranged. There are various types of plants belonging to different families. The mustard flower, which belongs to the family Brassicaceae, shows the presence of four whorls. And so, the flower is known as a complete flower. The outermost green-colored whorl is the calyx, which is made up of units called sepals. These sepals are free and so are called polysepals and exhibit imbricate estivation. Corolla is the next floral whorl. It consists of petals arranged in a cruciform manner. These petals are free and are known as polypetalous. They are arranged alternatively, with the sepals exhibiting valvate estivation. The arrangement of sepals or petals in the flower bud is known as estivation. The next inner whorl is the andrecium, which is formed of units called stamens. The six stamens are not equal in length. Of these, four stamens are tall and two stamens seen on the sides are short. This condition is known as tetradynamis. The stamens are dithicous. Genetium is the innermost whorl and consists of stigma, style and ovary. The ovary is bicarpillary and syncarpous. Let us now look at the hibiscus plant that belongs to the family Malvaceae. Hibiscus flower shows a calyx which is formed of fused sepals. There is another whorl of leaf-like structures known as the epicalyx. These sepals enclose brightly colored petals, the margins of which overlap each other to form twisted estivation. Enclosed within the petals is the andrecium, exhibiting a monodelphous condition. The stamens are arranged in one bundle and form the staminal tube. Each stamen has a filament and an anther which bears pollen. The innermost whorl is a genetium consisting of stigma, style and the syncarpous ovary with five locules. The ovary exhibits axile placentation. Let us now focus our attention on a sweet pea plant which belongs to the family Fabaceae. The pea flower shows outermost sepals which are all fused, and thus the calyx is gamosepalous. These sepals enclose brightly colored petals which are free, and hence the corolla is polypetalous. These petals are unequal in size and arranged in a butterfly-like manner. They consist of one large posterior petal called a standard, which is followed by two small lateral petals called wings. These wings in turn enclose the innermost boat-shaped keel. This keel is formed by the fusion of two anterior petals. Such an arrangement of petals results in vexillary estivation. The next floral whorl is the andrecium that comprises 10 stamens and is diadelphous. The anthers are dithicous. The genetium consists of the stigma, style and ovary. A longitudinal section of the ovary shows it is monocarpillary, unilocular and shows many ovules. The placentation is marginal. To summarize, we have learned about the floral arrangement in the families Brassicaceae, Malvaceae and Fabaceae. Brassicaceae is represented by the floral diagram of the mustard flower, Malvaceae by the hibiscus flower and Fabaceae by the sweet pea flower.